pogled na zemlju danas nas vodi u Tanzaniju. Ovo je Džavet, fotograf koji će nam otkriti tajne svog otoka Zanzibara. Na ovom tanzanijskom arhipelagu miješaju se boje Afrike i Orijenta, glazba i miris začina stapaju se s morem. Ali Tanzanija je poput velike knjige o džungli. Vodič Pascal povešće nas u obilazak prirode, očuvane kao u pradavna vremena. Kilimandžaro, najviši vrh Afrike, nalazi se na teritoriju naroda Uačaga, koji nastanjuje ovo područje. Maratonac Simon svjetski rekorder u broju uspona i silazaka s Kilimandžara. Ova je planina smisao njegova života.
Today we benefit greatly of this mountain. This is not only the Uačaga people, this is a treasure for my country.
Nošeni valovima Indijskog oceana pristajemo uz istočnu obalu Afrike. Zanzibar, otočje mitskog imena, 60. se godina prošlog stoljeća ujedinilo s obližnjom Tanganjikom u državu Tanzaniju. Od gotovo 75 otoka i otočića nastanjeno ih je samo 15. Zanzibar, nezaobilazna točka pomorskih ruta. Najveći i glavni otok arhipelaga zove se Unguja. Nekoć je čak nekoliko stoljeća to ime bilo sinonim važnog i moćnog trgovačkog središta. Luka iz koje su tradicionalni arapski jedrenjaci isplovljavali prema dalekim odredištima. Džaved je fotograf. On je i službeni fotograf Zanzibara. Njegova se obitelj iz Indije ovamo doselila prije više od jednog stoljeća. Već 15 godina Džaved svojim objektivom prati svaki trenutak života Zanzibarskog arhipelaga i dosad je snimio više od 50.000 fotografija. Kako bi objavio svoje radove, Džaved je osnovao vlastitu izdavačku kuću i otvorio knjižaru u glavnom gradu otoka Stone Townu. U prosjeku svake godine objavi 3 knjige svojih fotografija. Posvećene povijesti i kulturi njegove zemlje, te su knjige prevedene na mnoge strane jezike. Iako ovo zvuči kao fantastičan poslovni uspjeh, Džaved zapravo i nije imao drugog izbora. Uzastopne odbijenice velikih izdavačkih kuća da objave njegove radove prisilile su ga da uzme stvar u svoje ruke.
When I did my photography in UK, I had approached almost all the publishers in Europe and says, look, I've just finished and I'm going to Zanzibar and I want to do a book on Zanzibar. Everyone said, sorry, there's not market for Zanzibar. There's no commercial market. Zanzibar is too small. I mean, we do books where it would sell millions or at least 5,000, 10,000. I'd approach every big publishers. I'm talking about 93, 92, 94. Everyone said Zanzibar is not our market. So I said, well, if no one else wants to do it, I'm going to do it.
Džaved je pokrenuo i časopis o životu na Zanzibaru. Kao povlašteni svjedok svih lokalnih zbivanja pozvao nas je da ga pratimo pri njegovu radu. Slijedio je dinamičan i raznolik, vrlo zanimljiv radni dan.
That's the only one, yeah. Okay, that's the one which is going to go into that. Okay, so you're still following it up, eh?
Tog je jutra Džaved počeo pogleda uperenog prema gore. Želio je fotografirati boje prvih izdanaka nečega što je nama izgledalo poput najobičnijih pupoljaka.
This is the king crop of Zanzibar. Zanzibar has always depended on cloves. During 60s and 70s, Zanzibar used to earn export earnings on this. However, now tourism is taking more bringing more revenue in terms of cloves. Clove trees, when it's in season, you can smell cloves. Everywhere you go, you smell cloves, you see cloves. All the village people, everyone, they're working on the cloves. In the evening, they come and take all the cloves out from the tree. Next day, they put it on the floor and they dry it. So it takes 3 days, 4 days, 5 days. This is Zanzibar nutmeg and mace. And in Zanzibar, they make the powder of this. And they, for the wedding night, they always give it to bride. So she gets a bit of a high. And this is the secret of Zanzibar wedding. If there's no nutmeg and mace, there's no wedding in Zanzibar. Yes, smell of Zanzibar. The smell of Zanzibar wedding.
I sam spomen Zanzibara oduvijek se povezivao s trgovinom začinima. Kardamom, papar, muškatni oraščić, cimet, kumin, klinčić. Svi ti začini ovom su otoku donijeli ugled i bogatstvo. Stoljećima su mnogobrojni trgovci upravo zbog njih dolazili ovamo i ostajali, donoseći sa sobom svoju kulturu i običaje. Zanzibar, šarolika mješavina boja, mirisa, ali i različitih rasa i civilizacija. No, povijest Zanzibara ima i svoju mračnu stranu. Dugo vremena bogatstvo ovog otočja počivalo je i na trgovini robljem. Svake bi godine i do 50.000 ljudi bilo prodano na gradskoj tržnici i prolazilo dokovima Stone Towna, odakle su ih brodovima slali u druge zemlje. Unatoč ukidanju ropstva, ilegalna se trgovina ljudima potajno nastavila sve do završetka Prvog svjetskog rata. Ova je žena zasigurno jedan od posljednjih živih svjedoka toga tragičnog razdoblja. Biki Dude danas ima 98 ili 105 godina. Ni ona sama to ne zna točno. Ali Biki Dude nije popularna samo zbog svojih godina. Ona je ponajprije slavna pjevačica. Na Zanzibaru je njezin glas iznimno omiljen. Moglo bi se reći da je obožavaju. Džaved je upravo završio knjigu koja je njoj posvećena. I kao svaka velika zvijezda dala nam je autogram. Svoje ime napisala je na arapskom i to je jedina riječ koju je naučila napisati i zna pročitati.
Mene meimba mtoto wa miaka 10 na mpaka leo naimba. Huu mtu aliyemjifundisha kuimba mimi katika majaza malafubu. Simbe nitakula ni upepo.
Džaved nas zatim vodi da pogledamo, a ponajprije poslušamo ženski orkestar. Što li je neobično u grupi žena koje vole glazbu i sviraju je pod muškim vodstvom? Ali za ovdašnje žene to velik napredak. U zemlji koja stoljećima živi pod utjecajem arapske i afričke kulture, položaj žena u društvu još je na krhkim nogama. Stoga premijerni nastup ovog orkestra Džaved nikako ne želi propustiti.
You know, there are some people who do not allow their children or their daughters or their wives to perform with men, you know, men and women group. But they allow them to have to participate in women groups. So I think it's going to be an interesting, you know, very interesting to bring back these women groups whereby you find, because there are women who are very talented.
Well, these women started to play the music almost two and a half months, not years. Nobody can believe about this.
And it will be for Zanzibar, a new thing. And usually one starts, others start complaining, say, why women? And then, but then later, all of them support. This is how life is.
I dok smo još opčinjeni zvucima taraba i njegove čarobne harmonije različitih kultura, Džaved nas već vodi na drugi kraj otoka. Naše odredište je Uzi Island, otok zaboravljen u vremenu. Njegovi se stanovnici još boje stranaca i pri našem su dolasku u prvi mah pobjegli glavom bez obzira.
Bona na Kimbija! Bona na Kimbija!
Razlog Džavedova dolaska vrlo je jednostavan. Želi fotografirati mangrove koji su nakon dužeg razdoblja propadanja počeli ponovno rasti. Ovih nekoliko mladih izdanaka Džaved vidi kao simbol oporavka cijelog otočja.
Very nice. This mangroves is lost. I think it's just a new life has just grown over here. Very interesting. I like it.
Pri povratku iz biljnog labirinta jedan nas je stanovnik zaustavio. U prvo vrijeme Fazim se samo inicijativno proglasio čuvarom mangrova, ali danas to čini uz potporu lokalnih vlasti. Brine se za ovu krhku vrstu koja je nužna za ravnotežu biljnog i životinjskog svijeta i nadzire njezin razvoj.
In Zanzibar, only now two villages, big mangrove like this. Here Uzi and we call it Chwaka.
Chwaka, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So here we prepared or we protect. Any person don't come to cut it.
When they cut the mangroves, what do they use the mangroves?
They use for charcoals.
Okay.
So charcoals only.
Only charcoals.
And charcoals and to how to if you want to go now to build a house, you can just for put a tin on.
Boriti. Okay. So sasa hivi in Uzi Island you do not allow them to cut.
Yes, this. If you cut this, we're gonna at the police station and police come and mangrove has because mangrove to protect the bath. The fish is small. Big fish come inside and bath here.
So all the big fish they come here.
Yes.
And they give birth to babies.
Yes.
And they live here.
Yes.
Before they go out.
Yes. When the high tide they move.
Okay, so if we cut the mangroves, we have no fish.
Yes, no fish.
If there's no fish, no fishermen.
Yeah, no fishermen.
And that means we're all in trouble.
Yes.
Which is the same species?
This is the same type. This mucho. This and this.
So there are six species, you said, eh?
Five types of mangroves.
Or found on Uzi Island.
This is the seed of this type.
Okay.
So when you want to, they remove, they go like this. And this become how to grow. It grow itself. Don't come person to grow. It grow with itself. Yes.
Ali ne bude li se lokalno stanovništvo imalo čime baviti, ni očuvanje mangrova neće imati smisla. Stoga, da bi svi mogli i dalje sretno živjeti, potrebno je poboljšati životne uvjete stanovnika ovog otoka.
So this project of honey bee, how to prepare the honey. So we call this project of special for ladies of the village to prepare the to take honey and honey then they sold.
How many do you have this now?
This
how many
approximately more than 20 there's inside. So this called very nice honey for flowers of mangroves. Okay. But they normally they settle 3 months or 4th month they come to take off.
Čim smo se vratili na glavni otok Unguju, Džavet nas uvijek u pokretu već vodi u Nungvi, selo brodograditelja. Još od davnina ovdje se grade glasoviti brodovi zahvaljujući kojima je Zanzibar stekao ugled pomorske sile. Oni ih zovu Dao. Džaved je došao vidjeti kako napreduje izgradnja njegova broda. Njima će moći ploviti duž cijelog otočja, zaviriti u najskrovitije kutke svakog otočića, te nastaviti fotografirati mjesta koja mu toliko znače.
The people of Nungwi have been building the dhows for almost years, centuries. And this is the very famous place, all the master dhow men from Nungwi. And Nungwi is renowned for making dhows for a lot of... And the traditions are passed from father to son, father to son. This is how people have learned. So basically, Nungwi is the dhow capital of the world, I would say. I would say dhow capital of Zanzibar. And I think that's the way it is. It takes about 3 months to make a boat, and it involves a lot of people. So you're looking at about 7-8 people working on for 3 months by the time the boat is finished. So it's a long, tedious work, and everything is done by hand. It's a labor of love.
Bez ikakva nacrta, samo zahvaljujući oštrini svog oka i velikom umijeću, ovi ljudi grade brodove koji povezuju sve otočiće arhipelaga i uspijevaju odoljevati opasnoj hirovitosti Indijskog oceana. Iako su se vremena promijenila, iako je Zanzibar izgubio svoj ugled i bogatstvo, Džavedove otoke i dalje gleda očima punim ljubavi, a fotoobjektivom ovjekovječuje ljude i prirodne ljepote svoje opustošene zemlje. Pascal je profesor povijesti prirode. Danas u mirovini ovaj zaljubljenik u floru i faunu čudesno uočava i zna odgonetnuti svaku tajnu prirode koja ga okružuje. Trenutačno volontira u misiji promatranja i procjene tanzanijskih nacionalnih parkova. Nacionalni park Tarangire još nije u cijelosti istražen, pa je obilazak u njegovoj pratnji toga čudesnog utočišta divljine jednog od posljednjih iskonski netaknutih mjesta na zemlji poseban privilegij. Zahvaljujući Pascalu uspjeli smo dobiti dopuštenje da izađemo izvan označenih putova i sasvim se približimo divljim životinjama, a pritom uspješno izbjegnemo kadrove klasičnih dokumentaraca. Osjetiti, promatrati svakodnevicu životinja iz neposredne blizine neprocjenjivo je iskustvo.
I love nature, I love animals, I love the natural environment. I grew up as a young boy in the village, and we used to do a bit of hunting, and so I got used to wild animals, to birds, to plants and vegetation and natural environment. And then later on, as I grew up, I was trained as a naturalist and a wildlife manager.
U nacionalnom parku Tarangire živi jedna od najvećih kolonija slonova na svijetu. Dolaze ovamo privučeni močvarnim područjem uz rijeku Tarangire, po kojoj park i dobio ime. Močvarno područje ili swamp, kako ga ovdje zovu, ne privlači samo slonove, nego i sve ostale životinske vrste, kao i velika jata ptica selica koje ovamo dolaze svake godine. No, između svih životinja koje ovdje žive, Pascal posebnu naklonost osjeća upravo prema slonovima. Mogao bi provesti sate i sate promatrajući njihovo ponašanje i kretanje.
You know, they walk in a kind of an extended line. If you look at it, you'll see that you have the mothers, you know, leading the way, and then they have the, you know, the babies in between, and then you have some behind, just to make sure that the babies are well protected. And they're coming to graze now in the swamp and to drink too.
Ovdje životinje žive jedna uz drugu i svaka od njih ima svoje mjesto u prirodi. Životinje su potpuno slobodne, a ljudi moraju ostati u svojim vozilima unutar označenih putova. Opasnost je stvarna, jer ovo nije običan zoološki vrt. Stoga se životinje ničim ne smije uznemiravati.
The trunk has a lot of so many functions. For breathing, for you know, for drinking, it sucks in water, pumps it in the mouth. Yeah, and for smelling, you know, for fighting, you know, for love making, you know, caressing, it uses the same trunk. Yeah. When they are born, they weigh about 100 to 120 kilograms. They grow very quickly when they are young, and then when they start getting to at the age of 5-6, they grow now slowly.
Nakon što se okupe u blizini raznih izvora vode, slonovi se razdvajaju u manje obiteljske zajednice. Mladunci svakog trenutka uče, a svojom se surlom služe na isti način kao što djeca sišu palac. Slonovi su iznimno zaštitnički nastrojeni, pa je bolje poslušati Pascalove savjete i ne približavati im se suviše.
That is Tarangira Hill.
Završio je prvi slonovima posvećen dan našeg privilegiranog obilaska parka. Ali na povratku priroda nam je priredila još jedan posebni doživljaj. Kao u pradavna vremena, životinje ovdje žive u potpunu skladu sa svojim životnim navikama. Sljedećeg dana Pascal je primijetio tragove stada bivola. Odjedanput i sami smo osjetili kako je to kad te promatraju. Bivoli pripadaju velikoj petorci, odnosno skupini Big Five, kako Anglosaksi nazivaju pet najopasnijih životinskih vrsta afričke faune.
These are social animals that live in a big herd. They are fairly dangerous. They have killed a lot of hunters. Hunters who thought they are just like cows, but in fact they are not. They are very cruel, and if you come very close to their babies. These animals, there are times when they lose their temper. You know, for example, if they've been wounded by a bullet and they are solitary, they are hiding somewhere, don't get very close to them. You know, when they're having their afternoon siesta or just a nap, they are resting and they are solitary. Don't disturb them. If you do, they can be very wild. These are animals that can change their moods, like sometimes women can change moods too.
Blizina vode na području uz rijeku Tarangire privlači velik broj životinja, pa kad možete nabasati na divlju mačku koja bezbrižno ispružena na granama, vreba svoj plijen. Samo zahvaljujući uvježbanim Pascalovim očima primijetili smo leoparda koji se skrio u drveću. Činio se pomalo sramežljiv, ali i potpuno spreman suočiti se sa situacijom. Shvatio je da su na njegovu teritoriju uljezi.
I enjoy just being in the wild. It is interesting to visit, you know, to see these animals in their natural environment. They have different behaviors, different activities that they do, and it gives me a lot of spiritual satisfaction and recreation to some extent. So I really enjoy, I don't mind being out in the bush for 2 months. I'm just very happy.
U nacionalnom parku Tarangire, pomalo izdvojena od ostalih vrsta, živi velika skupina lavova koja je ovdje pronašla idealno i vrlo bogato lovno područje.
Lions are very common here in Tarangire, and as you can see in this river, where they've just killed a fresh zebra, and they love the zebra meat. The females are quick and fast, and they normally hunt as a team. So here, six of them have managed to hunt this zebra, and they are now feeding on it. Yeah, look over there.
Upravo pred našim očima lavica je krenula u lov. Ali ovog je puta zebra bila brža.
Usually these, you know, these animals, although they are social, but when it comes to table manners, I think they have the poorest of it. Because even if there's plenty of food here, they still scramble for food. And sometimes, even if there are cubs here, they will eat first and the cubs will eat later.
Lavlji je ručak poremetio dolazak nezvanih gostiju, vozila s rašljastom antenom. Zanimljiv pribor za promatranje lavljeg domnika. Ubrzo smo se upoznali. Riječ je o znanstvenicima koji proučavaju i prate kretanje različitih grupa lavova.
Yeah, we have about 6 radio callers that help us to follow the population trend, and also we collect range use pattern. We're estimating that the ecosystem has about 400 to 500 lions, the entire ecosystem, Tarangire and the surrounding areas. They're decreasing actually. Because of the human-lion conflict, the retaliatory killing from the pastoralists surrounding Tarangire National Park, and also the hunting activities.
I ostali čekaju svoj dio gozbe, poneprije strvinari, čistači parka.
You know, these are carrion eaters. And the reason why they're here is because they have spotted these lions eating this zebra meat here. So they are hanging around, you know, just waiting for the lions to go so that they can come close and feed on the leftovers. These birds are so important in the ecosystem because, you know, they're the ones who cleans up everything. Otherwise, the whole area would have been smelling, you know, awfully.
Dobro poznavajući svaki kutak ovog područja, Pascal nam je želio pokazati još jednu zanimljivost. Neobičnu životinju koju ljudsko oko vrlo rijetko može vidjeti uživo.
That is one of the largest monitor lizards around here, which has a total length of about 2.5 meters. And they are here because there is enough food for them. They feed on catfish. There are a lot of catfish in this swamp. Yeah, the lizard is there. It was trying to climb a tree, I think, to go and check if it can get some eggs of some birds, because it also feeds on eggs. Those are what you call Maasai giraffe.
And there are quite many in Tarangire. There are quite many, you know, moving around and feeding on the acacia leaves. You know, they are kind of prehistoric animals that, you know, still exist on Earth today. They don't have many predators because of their, they've got very powerful eyesight and they are fairly big. Because of their big size, the lions are the only predator that can kill, you know, the giraffe. And they wait until when they are drinking and they are bending their neck, then it is easy for them to ambush.
Dolazak u ovaj hram netaknute prirode Paskalu znači puno više od promatranja divljih životinja. Ovoga mjesto potiče i na druga razmišljanja.
I'm never bored with seeing these animals. I love coming to see these animals because they are quite interesting. You know, they are very refreshing. You know, they are beautiful to see. And every time I come here, it keeps my mind fairly cool, and so I have what you call peace of mind, you know, when I'm out. That makes life really good.
Planina, čudesna planina, Božji dom. Narodu koji živi na području Kilimandžara, najviša planina Afrike, pokazuje različita lica, pa je i zovu različitim imenima. Sa svojih gotovo 6000 metara visine, Kibo je najviši od tri vrha Kilimandžara i upravo je on simbol cijeloga planinskog lanca. Simon Mtui potomak je plemena Uačaga i ova mu je planina sve u životu. Imao je samo 16 godina kad se prvi put popeo na vrh Kilimandžara, svoje planine.
This is beautiful mountain. It has been my livelihood for 20 plus years of climbing this mountain and making my progress of life. It remain symbolic for Wachaga. It's a hidden place. It's a mountain of God, and when you get the punishment there from the cold, you have to believe it's a mountain that nothing exists there.
Za narod Uačaga ova je planina prebivalište duhova i dom njihova boga Ruve, koji može donijeti kišu i spriječiti oluju. Svoje pokojnike pokapaju licem okrenutim prema vrhu Kibo. Pa ipak, prema njihovu vjerovanju, ova planina nije prava koljevka naroda Uačaga.
On the other side of the mountain, more the southeast, there's a small mountain called as the Kifunika. This Kifunika is a mountain where the Chaga people believe that's where the origins of Wachaga. We go there from our worship, and this mountain has so many places where Wachaga people do their sacrifice.
Ali danas se Simon i njegov narod Uačaga suočavaju s bolnim pitanjem, budućnošću vrha Kibo i njegova ledenjaka. Znanstvenici vjeruju da će sav led nestati do 2020. ili najkasnije do 2025. godine.
When I was a child, as the age of 16, when I summited the mountain the first time, basically the glacier were way, way down halfway the mountain. And this glacier now, they are not longer existing. You can just see little spatch of the glaciers there, but it's almost gone. We need more scientific approval to understanding what is really going on this mountain. I feel sad. I feel like this is something that I would like my son or my children to come and see, to see these amazing glaciers. And when I visualize what I've seen, when I see what I've saw on the past, I feel imbalanced. I feel like something is missing.
Odrastao uz ovu planinu, Simon je zaljubljenik u trčanje, ili točnije profesionalni maratonac. Upravo on je 2006. godine oborio svjetski rekord u usponu i silasku s Kilimandžara za manje od 9 sati i 30 minuta. Svake godine sudjeluje na brojnim međunarodnim natjecanjima, posebice na sjeveru Amerike, gdje je ušao u uski krug najboljih u utrkama izdržljivosti. Gotovo svakog dana Simon trenira na obroncima Kilimandžara, upravo ondje gdje je rođen. Ova sitna žena s teškim teretom na glavi Simonova je 68-godišnja majka. Kao svi pripadnici naroda Uačaga, i ona svakog dana radi na obiteljskoj farmi. I čini se da nije pretjerano oduševljena sinovim sportskim aktivnostima.
Is it too much running? Is it too much running? It's okay for, but in the mountain, now come the money.
What you for?
He says it's not a very good place to go. He says Kifoni is like a death zone. It's not a very good place to go.
U ovoj je kolibi Simon rođen i odrastao uz devetero svoje braće i sestara. Njegova se obitelj čudi svaki put kad ga nakon boravka u Americi vidi kako se vraća u ovu kolibu. Ali Simonova opčinjenost ovom planinom jače od svega.
I'm very happy here to live my life in the village. And I go every year for running and I come back here. And my mother, she was very happy when I say to her, I go to America and I come back. And I go and come back. So even with my first time attempting to get a visa, it was very difficult to, because, for example, in American embassy, they have to ask you this question, what will make you to come back home? I say to them, my family. They say, what are you saying? I say, it's my family. So I come back for this. There's a good things on this country. Everything is possible here, and much easier than in US. You walk and you pay the bills. You walk, you pay the bills. Of course, you do the same here, but it's a different mentality.
Div od gotovo 2 metra, Simonov otac je u 85. godini života puca od zdravlja i brine se za svoju farmu. Ali njegova je prava strast uzgoj kratkonogih kokica, kako im od milja tepa, koje nesu najbolja jaja u selu.
See, this is the mother. All the chicken with the short legs.
Ndiyo msasi. Ndiyo salisha hii yote. Msasi.
It's a freedom. I feel there's nothing after this. My heart, my body, I feel refreshed after run. I like this every day. I do it after I walk all day in my farm. I run, and I come back, I swim. So I enjoy this very much.
Simon je iznimno ponosan na svoj vrt. Ovdje uzgaja povrće na potpuno prirodan način, bez umjetnih gnojiva i kemijskih dodataka. Rabi jedino kompost koji sam priprema.
My father, he didn't know how to read or to write. So he teaches us how to grow maize, how to grow coffee, how to work hard. And I think I take this forward from my grandfather to my father. And today I want my son to enjoy the same thing.
Kao i svi u Ačagi, i on je odličan poljoprivrednik. Uzgaja mrkvu, banane, rabarbaru, cvijeće i svoju kavu. 600 do 800 kilograma na godinu.
If I wish to do more commercial, I will spray a chemical, but I don't do it. It's just let the nature live itself.
No, najviše od svega ponosi se uspješnim uzgojem najegzotičnijeg voća u ovoj regiji. Jagoda koje poslužuje za stolom prenoćišta koje je sam izgradio da bi mogao ugostiti svoje goste, uglavnom Amerikance.
I think there is a reason for the clients to come to the village. There's a reason for the clients to come to enjoy the culture, to talk to the people, to see the people of Wachaga. And not only to be with them on the mountain, also to learn how their livelihood, besides going on the mountain, besides going on the safari. So I make sure the clients come here, they get the richness of this country.
Sudjelujući na maratonima i utrkama izdržljivosti, Simon je postao poznat u SAD-u i uspostavio brojna poznanstva. U svom prenoćištu sad prima i turiste koji su, poput njega, strastveni ljubitelji uspone na Kilimanjaro.
I want to make sure that everyone is aware of what you're going to go through. The climb is not a joke, it's not a walkabout, it's a mountain that you're going to climb. So you have to be very aware of what is going to go on with yourself. We know for sure the summit is not what brought you here, this experience. We want you to have a full of experience, experience that you wish to come here for.
I actually heard about Simon when I was on the top of a mountain in Colorado. Someone who knew Simon from the distance running told me about him and wrote down the website, and that's how I found it. I discovered about 3 years ago that I really liked climbing mountains, and I'm kind of good at it, and so I wanted to come here and climb Kilimanjaro and see Africa as well.
You need to make sure you're drinking, you're eating enough. You need to make sure you're sleeping enough. You need to make sure you're warm enough. And that when you arrive to the camp today, they're going to measure the vital sign again. What they're looking for is your O2 sat, your oxygen saturation, how much oxygen you carry in your body. Secondly, they're looking your heart rate.
There are several places I wanted to see in the world. I wanted to see Patagonia in South America and see Machu Picchu in Peru. But this has always been, I think, part of that dream is Africa and Kilimanjaro, as well as all the land around it.
And of course, we like you to have that dream to be on the top of Africa, the highest peak of Africa. We would like to be part of you to make sure, side to side, you're going to get that dream. For us here today, for me and my staff and the farm, this is our dream have come true. And we hope that by the end of the day, your dreams is going to come true.
stalnoj potrazi za novim idejama kojima će privući turiste u svoj kraj, Simon je u sklopu svog ekoturizma razvio novu aktivnost, biciklističku utrku oko Kilimandžara. Njegovi su prvi klijenti Peter i Tom, Amerikanci koji rade za lokalne nevladine organizacije. Obilazak cijeloga planinskog masiva, dugačak 200 km, traje oko tjedan dana i biti iznimno naporan. No Simon želi da stranci obiđu doista cijelu regiju i budu u direktnom kontaktu s lokalnim stanovništvom, kako bi što bolje upoznali njihovu kulturu i običaje. Nogama čvrsto na zemlji s koje je potekao, ali isto tako čovjek svog vremena, Simon, sin seljaka naroda Uačaga, ne ispušta mobitel iz ruku kako bi u svakom trenutku bio dostupan osoblju tvrtke koju je osnovao u gradu Moši, 40 km od svoje farme. Nekoliko puta na tjedan odlazi u svoj ured koji je izgrađen na temeljima od 3 reciklirana kontejnera. Uz pomoć tajnice i pomoćnika, Simon slaže rasporede turističkih obilazaka u organizaciji svoje tvrtke koja u razdoblju ekspedicije na Kilimandžaro svakog dana zapošljava 30 ljudi, uključujući vodiče i nosače. Simonu i njegovim gostima trebala su 4 dana da bi došli do zapadnog dijela Kilimandžara. U ovom dijelu planinskog masiva, rijeđe naseljenom i više pustinskom od istočne strane, često se mogu sresti divlje životinje koje migriraju u bijegu pred okrutnom sušom koja pogađa obližnju kenijsku visoravan. Obilazak biciklima nastavljaju područjem između Kilimandžara i Merua, drugog po visini afričkog vrha. Zahvaljujući ekspedicijama na vrh Kilimandžara i organizaciji biciklističkih tura, Simonovo je poslovanje krenulo u uzlaznom putanju. Poštujući prirodno okruženje i ne odustajući od svojih uvjerenja, Simon je uspio uskladiti tradicionalne običaje svoje zemlje s izazovima modernog svijeta, koji se brzo, sve brže mijenja. Ali više od svega ostalog, Simona obilježava privrženost i duboko poštovanje prema njegovoj planini.
This mountain supplies not only the climate, not only the glaciers, the water, the good weather around this mountain. And to today, we benefit greatly of this mountain. This is not only the Wachaga people, this is a treasure for my country.
Kilimandžaro je blago koje svake godine pokušava osvojiti više od 30.000 ljudi iz cijeloga svijeta. Simonu i njegovu narodu bogatstvo ove planine i zanimanje koje budi u ljudima omogućava da nastave živjeti na svojoj zemlji. Još otkad se kao 16-godišnjak prvi put popeo na svoju planinu, Simon je uspijevao ostvariti snove. Uzeo je sudbinu u svoje ruke. Na vlastiti je način postao simbolom nove, otvorene Afrike, koja je spremna udovoljiti znatiželji suvremenog svijeta.